Why spend money on a new soldering iron when your old one might just need a quick clean to work like new again? Most of the time, when a solder joint doesn't hold, or the tip won't melt, solder properly, it's not because your tool is broken, it's just dirty or oxidized. The good news is, you don't need fancy cleaners or new equipment to fix it. Today I'll show you a simple way to bring your old soldering iron back to life using things you already have at home. It's quick, safe, and will make your iron work like the day you bought it. Let's get started. Let's start by making a simple cleaning setup. Grab an empty plastic bottle and cut off the bottom. This will be our cup. Pour in some clean water. Then add about a tablespoon of regular table salt. Stir it well until the salt fully dissolves. This salty water will act as our cleaning solution. Now take the upper part of the bottle and cut out two small plastic rectangles. These will hold the soldering tip and a screw in place during cleaning. Use a drill or a heated nail to make one small hole in each piece so the two parts can sit side by side without touching. This setup keeps everything steady and safe while we run a small electric current through the solution. Simple, fast, and made entirely from things you already have at home. Now, let's build the small cleaning circuit. First, unplug your soldering iron and make sure it's completely cool. Take one white wire and connect it to the metal tip of your soldering iron. This will be the first contact point. Then take a red wire and attach it firmly to a metal screw. This will serve as the second electrode. Hey, I'm curious, where are you watching from? Drop your city or state down in the comments. Next, slide both the soldering tip and the screw through the two plastic pieces you prepared earlier. Make sure they're parallel but not touching each other. Keeping a small gap between them is very important. This setup will let the electric current flow through the salt water, later cleaning the surface of your soldering tip safely. Now let's bring the setup to life. Take a 12-volt, 1-amp charger, the kind used for small devices. Insert the red wire into the positive terminal of the charger plug. And wrap the white wire tightly around the metal shell of the plug. Use electrical tape to hold everything firmly in place so nothing moves. Once you're sure the connections are solid, lower both the soldering tip and the screw into the cup of salt water. Then plug in the charger. You'll start to see tiny bubbles forming around the soldering tip. That means electrolysis is working. The current is gently cleaning away the oxidation and burnt residue that built up over time. Let it run for a few minutes, then unplug the charger and remove the parts. You'll notice the tip already looks cleaner and shinier, ready for the final polish. Now it's time to see how well this cleaning method worked. Take the soldering tip out of the salt water and dry it carefully with a clean cloth or tissue. You'll see that the surface looks brighter and smoother than before. Reassemble your soldering iron, plug it in, and let it heat up for a minute or two. To test it, grab that loose wire from the power strip you were trying to fix earlier. Touch the soldering tip to the wire and apply a small bit of solder. You should notice right away how smoothly it melts and sticks. This time, no skipping, no dull surface, just a clean, shiny joint that holds tight. That's how you know the cleaning worked. After that, try a few more quick tests on different materials like small connectors or thin copper wires. If each solder point bonds easily, you've restored your iron's efficiency. This little trick not only saves you money on new tips, but also keeps your tools working like new for years. Simple, effective, and something you can do anytime your soldering iron starts to lose its edge. Sometimes even a clean soldering tip struggles to stick to certain metals like stainless steel filters or thin wires. When that happens, you can make a simple homemade flux. Grab a glass cup, squeeze in the juice from half a lemon, and add about a teaspoon of salt. Pour in a little warm water and stir until everything dissolves. The lemon acid helps remove oxidation while the salt improves conductivity and bonding. This natural mix works just like commercial flux, but it's cheaper and safer to use at home. Once it's ready, dip a cotton swab into the solution. We'll use it in the next step to help the solder flow smoothly and stick firmly. Now let's put that homemade flux to the test. This trick works great whenever you need to solder difficult metals like stainless steel or nickel. With a simple mix of lemon salt and water, you've just made a powerful natural flux that gets the job done without spending a dime. And there you have it. Your soldering iron is clean, powerful, and ready to handle any job again. You've learned how to restore a worn-out tip using just salt water and a simple 12-volt charger, and how to make your own natural flux from lemon and salt to solder tough metals like stainless steel. These little tricks save money, keep your tools in top shape, and make every project easier. If this guide helped you, hit the like button and share it with a friend who loves fixing things as much as you do. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you'll never miss the next DIY idea that could save your day. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.